We'll check out Comic-Con fan days.
We'll get fashionable at the Four Seasons.
And we'll have highlights from the Pat Mathers Scholarship Dinner.
All this and more coming up about Towne.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to About Towne. I'm Larry Stanley.
And I'm Kathy Whiteman, and I'm happy to welcome Larry back to the show. Looks like I didn't run you off, huh?
No, and no scary clowns around here to run me off. You know, so I had a great time last time. I thought I'd come back and do it again.
Well, I'm glad you did. And we're so glad that you could join us for a preview of the Lone Star Youth Orchestra's 2016-2017 season.
Stephen Jones joins us later in the show with details on lyric stage production of The Essing, and Scott Churchill reviews three new fall movies, including The Accountant.
As always, we invite you to email us. Let us know about stories you'd like to see and events you'd like to promote.
So please subscribe to our YouTube channel, like us on Facebook, and follow us on Twitter, or you can still email us at ictn@cityofirving.org.
The Four Seasons Resort celebrates fall by giving back to the community. For the second year, they hosted a fashion show that brought style and substance, raising money to fight breast cancer. Here's some highlights.
Models took the runway by storm in fashions by top designers.
Roberto Cavalli, Tori Burch, Ely Tahari, and some other great retailers.
And the ladies gathered in the Cottonwood Room at the Four Seasons Resort and Club got a great preview of this fall's best colors, fabrics, and trends. But along with the delicious champagne lunch and fall fashion preview, the ladies were there to help.
We're all here for a great cause because we all care about fighting cancer.
One in every eight women will be affected by breast cancer. And with all the progress that's been made, it's still a frightening proposition.
Patients are scared.
Phyllis Burton is Regional Director of Breast Imaging for Baylor Scott & White.
They're scared until they get that final result that says everything's fine, or we need to check something out further.
So early and accurate diagnosis is critical. This event is raising money to purchase state-of-the-art diagnostic equipment.
It takes very thin slices of images like a CT scan, so the radiologist can then see the various layers of the breast tissue in order to find those breast cancers much earlier at a very small size.
This past June, on my husband's birthday, I was diagnosed with breast cancer.
Sharon believes the digital mammography equipment saved her life.
The new 3D mammography machine was able to detect my cancer sooner than regular mammography machines used to be able to detect it. And because of that, I was able to get through this process without chemo or radiation.
Proceeds from the second annual Fashion at Four Seasons will help to purchase more digital mammography equipment. The success of these events and others will allow the Four Seasons to support even greater efforts as they reach for a major goal.
This year, our goal is to reach that $3 million milestone. And with everyone's help through our charitable events throughout the month of October, we're hoping to raise $135,000. And that will put us at that $3 million.
This is Kathy Whiteman reporting.
Up next for the Four Seasons, the Cool October Concert on Saturday, October 29th at 7 p.m. Visit cooloctober.com for the details.
The Pat Mathers Scholarship Foundation raises money to help college-bound students whose parents work for the Irving Police Department. About Towne was there for the 9th annual foundation dinner honoring the families of Irving's first responders.
I want to say thank you. This is an important event.
Fran Mathers, owner of Via Real in Las Clinas, recently hosted the 9th annual Pat Mathers Scholarship Dinner.
This all got started with Pat Mathers, which was Fran's late husband. He had a fantastically amazing relationship with the police chief back then for the Irving Police Department. Then these guys actually used to ride motorcycles together, so it was awesome to kind of hear that and kind of grow up. So whenever Pat passed away, Fran got with the police chief and wanted to start some sort of a foundation with it. And so they decided to do the Pat Mathers Scholarship Foundation. So it's pretty awesome.
Those applying for the Scholarship Foundation must be children of the Irving Police Department employees and college bound. Applicants then submit a 3-page essay in addition to listing their community involvement.
We have a grading panel that are all educators that grade the essays blindly. And then all of that's put together into a formula, and we come up with high scores.
Four students were presented with scholarships. And for recipient Michaela Moore, this award came just in the nick of time.
She needed $5,000, and she needed it before school started, and we were discussing, oh, well, I'll take it out of my savings or whatever we're going to do, or you know, and within a week or two of having that discussion, you know, we were honored with the award, and it was the timing couldn't have been better.
Along with benefiting these young scholars, this event is also about a night of entertainment, which included a delectable four-course dinner, live music, a live auction, and something new.
Our highlight is the honor guard ceremony for the police department. They all showed up and said they would come in and do their ceremony, and they're going to sing the national anthem.
The Pat Mathers Scholarship Dinner is ultimately about giving back for a good cause, all while having a good time.
Some live entertainment by Al Nelson, and just enjoy some dancing and good times and just have a blast.
For About Town, this is Susan Kamyab.
To learn more about the Pat Mather Scholarship and how you can help, visit viareal.com/about/scholarships.
The Lone Star Youth Orchestra tunes up for their 2016-2017 season, and Orchestra General Manager Alice Ford joins us with the details. Alice, it's so nice to see you.
Thank you so much for having me.
Well, the Lone Star Youth Orchestra has been around for a while now, but for folks in the audience who may not have been to a concert recently, let's give them a little bit of background.
Absolutely. So the Lone Star Youth Orchestra is an education initiative of the Las Colinas Symphony Orchestra, and it's for middle school and high school students that live anywhere in the DFW Metroplex. It provides those students an opportunity to excel in their musical training and provides them something extra from their school schedules. What's great about the Lone Star Youth Orchestra is we're one of the only tuition-free youth orchestras in North Texas. So we don't charge our members a fee to participate. And any nominal fees that there may be, there's a scholarship available. We also provide students with the opportunity to audition anytime throughout the year. So if you're really busy in the fall with sports or marching band or anything like that, you can audition for us in the middle of the season. We really just want kids to have the opportunity to experience music.
I think that that's extraordinary because, you know, kids are super busy nowadays with school and extracurriculars. And if they want, because the music is not something that you can accomplish by wishing it would happen, you've got to play the music, you've got to practice, you've got to get in there and make it happen. And you guys have had some wonderful successes over this 17 years now.
We have, absolutely. We have alums who have done some wonderful things, not only in music, but in other fields as well. We have alum who have gone to local universities such as SMU, TCU, but we've also had alums go to the Royal Academy in London and even as far as Juilliard. So there's just a breadth of knowledge and experience that you can gain from being in part of the Lone Star Youth Orchestra.
Not to mention how much fun you guys have, especially with the music that you're playing, you know?
Absolutely. We want the kids to experience not just the classical stuff, but also give them some fun and exciting repertoire as well. So this season we're doing four fun concerts. Our first one's actually November 9th at 7 p.m. at the Irving Arts Center, and we're going to be looking at a British invasion. So all of your favorite British composers, we're going to have some selections from Phantom of the Opera, so there's going to be some great stuff that you'll recognize on that performance.
Yeah.
In December, we're actually part of the Irving Arts Center's open house, so there's some fun Christmas music on that one, and that's always fun for all ages. In the spring, what's great about the two concerts in our spring semester is we actually feature two students as soloists. We have a concerto competition and offer some of our students scholarship money for their future education endeavors. And so in the spring, we'll be focusing those students as soloists and just be having a ton of fun.
Absolutely. I love the fact that you guys are making this kind of an opportunity to perform in a beautiful space, beautiful music, and give them an opportunity to really get a foundation under them. So if they do want to pursue music performance, they've got what they need to know already in place.
And we try to give them the most professional experience possible. So they perform in the exact same venue that the Las Colinas Symphony performs in, and they are working with sectional coaches and teachers who are professional musicians in this area, so they're really getting to learn firsthand experience from musicians who are making this a career.
That's so exciting. That's wonderful. So folks, if you want to see this great group of young musicians in concert, the first one's coming up November 9th.
Yes, ma'am.
That's Wednesday evening, November 9th at 7 p.m. in Carpenter Performance Hall. If we want more information, what's a website?
Great website to go to would be lascolinasymphony.org, and on the top of the menu screen, there's an education section that'll tell you all about the Lone Star Youth Orchestra.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for
being here.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Looking forward to that concert.
Yes, ma'am.
Back to you, Larry.
Scott Churchill returns to About Town with a look at American Pastoral and The Accountant.
American Pastoral marks the directorial debut of Ewan McGregor, who also stars in the film along with Dakota Fanning and Jennifer Connelly. It weaves an unsettling story of post-World War II America, exposing an underbelly of the American dream. Like other movies exploring the contradictions of the 1950s, such as Revolutionary Road and Far From Heaven and Carol, American Pastoral, with its painterly cinematography, shows us beautiful surfaces and ugly depths, suggesting that the veneer of happy family life, often used to depict post-war America, only served to mask the societal flaws that gnawed away at the fabric of our lives, especially after the Vietnam era of constant violence both at home and abroad. Race riots, the endless bombing of Hanoi associated with the Johnson administration, and protests against social injustice around the world, captured in vivid television images, serve as cinematic hints to allow viewers to construct their own understanding of the deeper message of this film.
Police have widened their search for the missing teenager, Meredith Laval, for her involvement in the bombing of a post office.
Based on the novel by Philip Roth, known for his poignant social commentaries and penetrating characterizations of our society, American Pastoral will haunt you for days, even weeks, after viewing it.
Your son is a remarkable young man. He has highly advanced cognitive skills. He has more in common with Einstein or Mozart than he does with us. I'd like to work with your son. Help him develop the skills he'll need to lead a full life.
It's not gonna happen. The world is not a friendly place, and that's where he needs to learn to live.
How did you get into financial consulting?
My dad was an accountant. You know, he had the whole shtick, the dorky pocket protector.
I have a pocket protector.
That's a nice one.
The Accountant co-stars Ben Affleck, J.K. Simmons, and Anna Kendrick in a psychological thriller about an autistic savant who grows up to be a money launderer for unsavory characters around the globe. J.K. Simmons is a U.S. Treasury agent on his trail, and Anna Kendrick is the hapless, lovelorn CPA who stumbles into his life.
Do you like puzzles? Tell me what you see. It was taken 3 years ago by an undercover agent.
It's the same person.
He was spotted in Tehran, Tel Aviv, and Naples. This guy risks his life uncooking the books for some of the scariest people on the planet. Imagine the secrets this guy has.
What are you doing here?
Who are you?
With the exception of some minor plot flaws, the film goes by like a roller coaster ride and offers a very satisfying movie experience. We'll close with this clip from American Honey, perhaps the riskiest and most provocative and innovative film to be released this fall. Dallas native Sasha Lane stars in this road film that amounts to a sociological study of the wayward youths who find their way into what are known as mag crews, bands of young people pulled off the street by unsavory exploiters who trek them across the country selling magazines. What makes this film so special is the standout performance of Sasha Lane as the film's protagonist star, and Shia LaBeouf's supporting role as her handler, which just might earn him an Oscar nomination. Sasha Lane is so perfect for this role that it seems as though writer-director Andrea Arnold just turned on the camera and let it roll. Lane's energy and spiritual strength is what carries this film throughout its 2 hour and 40 minute duration. She might even garner some acting award nominations for her performance.
Hey!
Where are you going?
To make money!
Hop in.
This is not a film for everybody, but if you are into cutting-edge cinema at its very best, American Honey just may be the best new film of the season.
American Pastoral opens October 21st. Check your local listings for theaters and showtimes. The Accountant is playing at AMC Irving Mall and Regal MacArthur Marketplace.
Lyric Stage brings the music of George and Ira Gershwin to Carpenter Performance Hall. Steve Jones brings us the details. Great to see you, Steve.
Always great to see you, Kathy.
So, of Thee I Sing, on stage at the Carpenter, tell me about the show.
Well, first of all, the music is by George and Ira Gershwin, so you know the music is spectacular. And it's actually Lyric Stage's first time to produce a Gershwin musical.
Oh my gosh.
Long overdue here in our 24th season.
Yeah.
And I selected it because it is about a presidential campaign. And we run the weekend before the presidential election.
Oh my goodness, so we're talking timely here.
Very timely. It's political satire. And it was actually the first musical to win the Pulitzer Prize for Drama back in 1932.
Oh, that's fabulous.
It's very, very relevant today, and it is crazy. The plot is really, really crazy. It's about a political party that's trying to determine what their platform is for the presidential race. And there aren't Democrats and Republicans. There are two parties, but they don't discuss names or anything. Okay. And they're meeting in a hotel, and so they call the maid over and say, "What is really important to you?" And she said, "Money." He says, "Well, no, besides money, what's important?" She says, "Love." That's it. We're going to run on the love platform.
Oh,
so that's what it is. They run on love. Have a beauty contest to pick the first lady, and the guy who's running for president makes a promise that he will marry whoever wins this Atlantic City beauty contest. Well, he happens to fall in love with his secretary on the way, so he doesn't marry the winner. All kinds of problems ensue. She's from France. Well, she's from the United States, but by way of France, the French ambassador gets upset. There's impeachment proceedings. It's really funny.
Okay, so this sounds insane, which means it's really relevant.
Very relevant. Very relevant.
So what music will we recognize from the show?
You'll recognize the title tune of Thee I Sing, Baby. And that was controversial, putting that word baby on there, belittling. But it became a big hit back in 1931. And then the other song that I think everybody will recognize is Love is Sweeping the Country, which is very appropriate for this candidate running on the love platform. But you can't make up the nonsense. Like, we think what we're living through right now is really outrageous. Well, the plot of this musical is, it kind of makes it seem tame, actually, maybe, compared to what we're going through live right now. But it's fun. Everybody needs to come and laugh, because
yeah.
It really is funny.
Yeah, well, I will agree with you on that one. So when is the show opens on November 3rd?
November 3rd. It's Thursday, Friday, Saturday evenings at 7:30 this year.
Okay.
And then there is an additional matinee on Saturday, November the...
I guess that's the fifth, yeah.
And then there's a matinee on November 6th on Sunday at 2:30. Both those matinees are at 2:30.
That's fantastic. So, Steve, we are looking forward to this. What a fun idea to do of Thee I Sing and to finally bring some Gershwin to Lyric Stage.
Absolutely.
Yeah, thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Back to you, Larry.
There's nothing like Comic-Con fan days to get the cosplayers out, ready to celebrate the release of their favorite new movies and TV shows. Our resident Star Wars geek was there, and she says the Force was definitely strong at fan days.
Fans of all ages and stages of cosplay were thrilled to hear these words.
Dallas Fan Days 2016 is open now for all ticket holders.
Are you recording?
They came looking for the ultimate fan experience, but I was looking for something very specific.
We're here at the Irving Convention Center. It is Fall Fan Days at Comic-Con, and what do I see everywhere?
Meet the Chenault family. Dad Kyle, Mom Leah, Big Brother Thayer, Little Brother Sawyer, and Brother from Another Mother, Justin Jones. All cosplay ready and all on board for the Star Wars experience at Fan Days.
May the Force be with us.
Well, it is a family affair. It's
Kyle is Han Solo, of course, but let's meet the rest of the crew.
I'm Boba Fett. He's the lead bounty hunter, first seen in The Empire Strikes Back. And, I mean, he's well-renowned as probably one of the best villains in sci-fi history.
It's Mara Jade. That is Luke Skywalker's wife.
I'm Dengar. He's a bounty hunter. He was in The Empire Strikes Back. They were searching for Han Solo. He's actually, if you read the books, he's a friend of Han Solo, and he pulls him out of the Sarlacc pit.
Yes, a Jawa. I'm trying to make sure I ain't getting mixed up with Ewok.
Of course he's a Jawa. They all look the part, and that's part of the fun, because serious cosplayers create their own costumes and props. For the Chenault family, that role falls to Kyle.
I'm self-taught, so I go on. YouTube is a valuable resource for anybody that wants to get into cosplay, costuming.
He's very talented. He puts everything together. He's like a MacGyver.
And there's multiple tutorials on how to do things, whether it's sewing, whether it's foam fabrication.
My dad would kind of use me as a prop. I would try all of the equipment on, help out with some of the painting.
He just can like look at stuff and make stuff out of nothing. Yeah, I'm really proud of him.
The time and effort is the biggest part of it.
I fear nothing.
The fun they have at Comic-Con makes it worth all the effort.
Walking around and getting like photos taken.
Hanging out with my family, getting to see new people.
Hanging out with my brother and his family. That's it.
Take hold of this moment. The force is strong.
Comic-Con fan days can be summed up in just one word, according to Sawyer.
Amazing!
This is Kathy Whiteman reporting.
Visit IrvingConventionCenter.com and click events to see what's coming up next.
Artist Patsy DeVilla's show, Do the Can-Can, is on display in the West Gallery at the Center for the Arts at J.C. Park through October 28th. You'll see recycled items used in very creative ways in this exhibit. Here's a preview and a list of ways for you to kick up your heels about town. And here's some other exciting events happening about town. Main Stage Irving Las Colinas kicks off their 2016-2017 season with a cabaret show called Laughing Matters, starring Dallas favorite B.J. Cleveland. The show is Friday, October 21st at 6 p.m. in the Dupree Theater. Visit Irving Theater, that's with an R-E.org, to learn more.
The fifth annual exhibition of Islamic art continues with a presentation on architecture, followed by a performance by Aga Khan Foundation Choir. That's Saturday, October 22nd at 4 p.m. in the Dupree Theater. And the Irving Public Library celebrates the season with a spectacular fall carnival on Friday, October 28th from 7 to 10 p.m. at the South Irving Library. And that wraps up this edition of About Town. Thanks for joining us.
Please be sure to tune in next time for a preview of the hit musical Chicago, opening Main Stage Irving Las Colinas' Razzle Dazzle season.
We'll also meet Irving artist Robert Batson and bring you some highlights from the Big Read 2016.
We'll leave you tonight with more from the Main Street Event 2016. For About Town, I'm Kathy Whiteman.
And I'm Larry Stanley. Have a great evening, About Town.